I can hear myself now. That's the important part. I can hear myself. Good evening. Welcome to Enfield Congregational United Church of Christ this evening. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. We are currently in the second quarter of the University of Georgia versus UT Martin. The University of Georgia is winning. I'm not saying that I'm going to be watching it during this concert. I'm just going to say that David is now going to lead us in the University of Georgia alma mater. Please rise. Just joshing with you. I mean, maybe not. But that's for tomorrow morning, right? No, because we don't play loser songs there, dear. That's okay. So, friends, we are here for our Rhoda Smith concert series. Rhoda Smith was a matriarch of this church that some of you may know personally. Some of you may have never met her. But Rhoda did a wonderful job of taking care of this church when she was here with us and wanted to make certain that this church was taken care of in her absence. And so she left money to this church for us to take care of all kinds of different things. And one of those things that we are doing with that is this concert series. And we have had all kinds of concerts. We have had country and jazz and everything in between. So we are really enjoying these concerts that we have here at the church. These concerts are all free of charge, and we want to make certain that everybody knows that these concerts are free of charge, but the concerts do indeed come with a price tag. So the concerts are free to you, but that doesn't mean that the church doesn't have expenses. So the thing that I want to tell each of you that are here tonight is I hope that you enjoy the concert, and we want to make certain that you have a great time here and that you come back to our next concert and the one after that. And you never think that these concerts are going to be outside of your price range, because these concerts are indeed free. But I want you to think about how much you would spend for a ticket to a concert tonight. What would you pay to come to a concert like this one? And there are indeed vases that are going to be up here. I'm probably going to hit you up again at intermission, kind of like a PBS special. And so you can be prepared for an update on the football score and a hit up for the Rhoda Smith Concert Fund. Friends, I want to tell you this as well. Yesterday was David's anniversary at the church. He has been with us for 1 year as of yesterday. And folks, what a year it has been. We enjoy hearing from him every Sunday morning at 10 a.m. So if you enjoy tonight, just come back until Sunday morning, 10 o'clock. Or, it depends on how long the concert goes, just stay. But friends, help me welcome David Kidwell.
Thank you all so much. Thank you, Greg. Thank you for being here tonight. I couldn't think of a better way to celebrate my one-year anniversary than doing a concert. So thank you for your support over the past year, and thank you for being here tonight. I apologize to Greg for not checking the University of Georgia schedule. I think we're going to have to, somebody's going to need to confiscate his phone during the concert. Just two quick things. For people sitting downstairs, you're more than welcome to come up. If you're getting a crick in your neck from turning around, there are plenty of seats. Actually, nobody is sitting behind the organ. We have like 15 seats behind the organ here. You're welcome to come up. Likewise, if people are up here and it's just too loud and you need to escape, you're welcome to go downstairs. It will not bother me at all if people are moving around. Just please be careful on the stairs, because they are treacherous. I know I'm going to slip and break my neck going up and down these stairs one Sunday morning. And the other thing is applause. please do. Whenever you feel like it, you do not have to wait till the end of a section to applaud. And likewise, if a song ends quietly and you just want to go, that's perfectly okay too. One thing that I do request is that you not clap while I'm actually playing. Those of you who come on Sunday mornings know that your rhythm is getting better, but it's still a little bit suspect. Two and four, yes. So thank you so much for coming. I hope you enjoy things tonight. My first set is a group of arrangements of African-American spirituals. I dearly love spirituals. They are so beautiful and powerful. And as you'll see, they lend themselves really well to being arranged in a lot of different musical styles. So I hope you enjoy these selections from That Promised Land. Thank you. Thank you so much. I wanted to say that this is actually, if you don't know, this is not a pipe organ. Despite the beautiful pipes that you see up here, they are just for show. They're left over from a pipe organ that was here at one time, but now they make no sound at all. Actually, most of the sound you're hearing is coming from speakers mounted behind these pipes here, but they are nice to look at. This is a Rogers electronic organ, and I think it does a really nice job of emulating the sound of a pipe organ, and also just the feel and the layout of a pipe organ, so I'm really enjoying playing it. The next piece is an original piece. It's in three movements, called Sweet Antique. And antique just means it's in a slightly old-fashioned traditional musical style. The first movement is a gently moving preamble or prelude. The second movement, pastoral, if you think sheep and shepherds and open fields and pastures, you'll be on the right track. That features a lot of the flute and oboe sounds of the organ, which are very symbolic of pastoral music. And the third movement, quadlibet, is just a fancy word for mashup. If you've heard two songs that are mashed up together, that's what this is. This is with two different themes. You'll hear one theme, you'll hear a second theme, and then you'll hear them played, both themes played simultaneously. So I hope you enjoy Sweet Antique.
Thank you.
Thank you. So I talked earlier about mashups, and the next two pieces, each one is a mashup of two different hymns. And the two hymns that are paired, I chose them because they are a little bit similar melodically, and they also share a common liturgical theme, liturgical time of the year. And so they work, I think they work very well musically as well as theologically. This is from a book called Hymn Mixtures. I really wanted to call the book Hymn Mashups because they're all mashups. And I think that's a great title, but my publisher disagreed and said that that wasn't serious enough for an organ book. And so they called it Hymn Mixtures. And I guess I should be happy that they didn't do something worse like Hymn Quadlibets. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. One of the most important skills for an organist to have is the ability to improvise. If you think about a communion service, when people are coming up and partaking of the elements, you never know exactly how long that's going to take, so you just have to keep playing until it's done. In our own services on Sunday mornings, if you think about our liturgy, when we welcome new members, I never know how long Greg is going to talk about casseroles, and so I just have to keep playing. One of the most amazing improvisations, organ improvisations, that I've ever heard was at the Cathedral of St. John the Divine in New York City. And this was for a summer solstice event. The Paul Winter Consort does both summer solstice and winter solstice concerts. For the summer concert, they start playing at 4:30 in the morning in the sanctuary in total darkness, and they play and they improvise for about 2 hours until the sun comes up. And the last 20 minutes leading up to the sunrise is an organ improvisation. And the organist starts from the softest organ stop, so you can barely hear it, and he gradually adds and adds, and it gets louder and louder until right at the sunrise, he adds the final stop, which is the state trumpet, and it's one of the loudest organ stops in the world, and it's just a thrilling experience. I'm going to try to recreate that. We do have a nice loud trumpet stop on the organ, as you just heard in that last piece. I'm not going to go 20 minutes. I'm going to aim for like 10 to 12, something like that. But I do want to capture the general flow of it and the gradual build. This is all improvised, but I do have a particular hymn in mind, and you might hear little snippets of that weaving in and out of the texture. You'll hear the hymn in its entirety played on the trumpet at the end of the improvisation.